Hello, everyone. In this video, we'll explore how to efficiently organize and manage data assets in Google Cloud. We will also discuss running data quality scans to ensure that our data remains reliable and accurate. Currently, I'm in the Dataplex system, specifically in the Search Console, where we can view all the assets we have across various platforms like BigQuery, Cloud Storage, Spanner, and other databases. We can search by data type or even data lake or zone, which are logical ways to organize our data assets. Data types offer an additional method to quickly discover and link out to different data assets, while projects and tags provide even more options for analysis. For example, using tags, we can identify when the owner of an asset is our demo user, as seen in these two tables here. Let's dive into a few ways that we're using metadata and elements of the Dataplex platform to organize our data. Tag templates provide a structured way to attach metadata to datasets. You can either choose from some predefined options or create one from scratch. For instance, we could create a tag template for the purpose of the data. With public visibility, users who view the datasets can also view the associated tags. However, if we want to manage permissions separately, we can opt out for private visibility. For our purpose tag template, let's keep it simple with a rich text purpose field and a contact field for an email. Now let's apply the tag template we've created to a dataset. In our data lakes, we can see some data assets organized logically into raw zones, which include structured, unstructured, and semi-structured data, as well as curated zones. We'll add a zone here, noting that a curated zone means we have a Hive-compatible directory layout, offering a bit more structure to our data lake zone. Within our new zone, let's go to entities, which are at a more granular level than assets and include items like tables. We'll attach our tag template to the shipments table and apply it to the full table rather than a column. Now, if we go back to the Search Console, we have the option to find this dataset based on its purpose, using the contact email as an example. There's our shipments table. Entry groups help manage and create entries for cloud storage file sets or custom data types. For example, we could have an analytics entry group and populate it with file sets from cloud storage. Glossaries help us organize and standardize business terminology, and they can contain terms linked to related terms, synonyms, and descriptions. This can be valuable for calculated fields and implementation-agnostic understanding. Dataplex also allows us to define permissions based on logical structures such as data lakes and zones, which then propagate to assets within those groupings. The Secure tab gives us visibility into permissions, showing where we've assigned them. Processes enable us to run data pipelines, data quality checks, or custom Spark jobs, which can be structured as queries or notebooks. One notable feature is the data quality check, which uses the Cloud DQ, Cloud Data Quality, project and YAML configurations to run data quality checks either on demand or on a schedule. Next, let's take a look at the attribute store, which provides a taxonomy for data attributes that can be added to datasets. Unlike tags, attributes are single labels assigned to datasets. Data profiling and data quality scans are essential tools for maintaining the reliability and accuracy of your data assets. For example, data profiling jobs can provide valuable insights into your data's distribution, such as average lengths, uniqueness, null counts, and other statistical measures. These insights can help you better understand your data and identify potential issues or areas for improvement. On the other hand, data quality scans enable you to compare the actual characteristics of your data with your expectations. By defining specific rules such as uniqueness constraints, you can check whether your dataset meets the standards you've set. This ensures that your data remains reliable and trustworthy for analysis and decision making. To perform a data quality scan, you can either choose from predefined rules or leverage recommended rules based on profiles that have already been run on your data. For example, you might want to check the uniqueness of email addresses in a newsletter signup dataset. You can select a predefined uniqueness rule, specify the email field, and run the scan on demand. Alternatively, you can select a profile scan of your newsletter fields and choose a recommended uniqueness rule based on the profile. It's important to note that both per row and aggregate evaluations are possible, allowing for flexibility in how you assess your data. Once the data quality scan is complete, you can view the results to determine whether your dataset has passed the check. In our example, if the uniqueness constraint is met, the data quality check will show that it has passed, ensuring that the email addresses in the newsletter signup dataset are unique. We hope this overview has given you a quick taste of how to manage, discover, organize, and govern data in Google Cloud using Dataplex. If you have any questions or need further clarification, please don't hesitate to leave a comment. Thank you for watching.